Hello friends, welcome to the Tetrahedron chemistry classes. So in today's class we will see the numericals which have been asked in the previous year JAM examination, and the section of the numericals would be your electrode potential based on the Nernst equation, right, as well as the free energy, right. So here you can see I have some numericals which have been asked in the previous examination. So this is your first numerical. As you can see here, the reaction is given in this case, and electrode potential is also given, concentration of iron, pressure of oxygen, and pH is also given, and you have to find the cell potential of the electrochemical cell. And this question is from 2011 JAM examination. So very quickly we'll see how we can solve this particular one. So this numerical is based on the Nernst equation actually, and the Nernst equation I have explained in my previous lecture. So if you haven't seen my previous lecture on electrochemistry, so here is the link, you can go for you can go through the links and see how we can solve the Nernst equation. So very quickly we'll see. This is the given question actually, and if you rewrite the reaction here, then you will find in this reaction your 2 of iron reacting with oxygen and with acid producing your iron, that is Fe2 positive, right? This is 2, and of course this is the H2O. So what is happening here, your iron is undergoing oxidation, right? So this is oxidation, and you see oxygen here, it is having, see here iron is going from 0 to plus 2, but here oxygen is going from 0 to minus 2. So your oxygen is reducing, right? So this part is the actually the reduction part. So you know how we can derive the Nernst equation for this one if you want to calculate. So E cell you have to calculate, that would be equal to E standard cell negative 0.0591 divided by number of moles of the electrons log of concentration of Fe2 positive ions. Always oxidized, when you have the negative sign here, then your oxidized form would go to the numerator, right? And this Fe2 positive is having the stoichiometric coefficient of 2, so it will go to the power, right? Similarly, you can divide, you see what is happening here, H positive are there actually. So these H positives you can take into consideration, concentration of these H positive ions. So you can write H positive here, and in this case C stoichiometric coefficient is what? It is 4 actually. So you can write the power of 4. Similarly, you have also given the pressure of the oxygen, right? 0.1 atmospheric pressure. So along with this you will also write the pressure of the oxygen here. Now you can argue why we are putting the pressure of the oxygen here, while in the other cases I am we are having the concentrations, right? So remember, in the for the dilute solutions, your dilute solutions obeys the gas law equation. So it doesn't matter whether you put the pressure of the oxygen or the concentration of any other species, both are equivalent in case of the dilute solution. So this is how your equation looks like, right? And you have to calculate this particular one, and further solving it, then you can solve in this way. E standard cell, this E standard cell is not given actually in the question. So it is given actually, I have written here, this E cell in the question, you can see, okay fine, it is given, it is 1.67 volt, it is given 1.67 volt. So I'm writing E standard here, which is given again 1.67 volt. So here you will write 1.67 minus 0.0591 divided by number of moles of electrons. How many number of moles of electrons are involved? You know, Fe2 positive is forming from your Fe actually. So number of moles of electrons are 2. That means 2 moles of electrons are involved in this particular reaction. So straight away you can write 2 here. And you see 4H positive are there. So instead of writing this H, 4H positive, so you will write 4, not 2 actually, because 2, 0 and 2, 2's are 4. Similarly, 4 ones are 4, 4 positive are there, it will consume 4 moles of the electrons deposit the product. So however, you can see how these reactions are going on actually. So this is log again. Concentration of Fe2 positive is given, that is 10 raised to the power minus 3. Fine. And this is the power of 2. And concentration of hydrogen is also given. How this concentration of hydrogen is given? Your pH is given. pH equals to 3, right? Which corresponds to the 10 raised to the power minus 3 H positive ions, right? This is very, very important to understand. How you can think in this way? You know, pH is equals to negative log of hydronium ion concentration, right? This pH is given, that is pH equal to negative log of H3O positive concentration, fine. If you take the anti-log of 3 and change this value, then it will come out 10 raised to the power minus 3. This is the one way of thinking. So there is a key point, you should remember this particular one. If pH is 10 raised to the power minus, if pH is 3, then hydrogen ion concentration would be 10 raised to the power minus 3. If pH is 4, then it would be 10 raised to the power minus 4. If it is pH is 5, then it would be 10 raised to the power minus 5. So for this pH 3, I will write 10 raised to the power minus 3 again here, right? So you can write 10 raised to the power minus 3. And of course, you see stoichiometric coefficient is 4. You will write 4 here. And pressure of the oxygen is given 0.14. Now this equation is ready actually. How you can solve it? 1.67 0.0591 divided by 4 log of 10 raised to the power minus 6, 2 3 is 6 and 4 3 is 12. And you see 4 3 is 12, so you can write here 10 raised to the power minus 12 into 10 raised to the power minus 1, because 0.1 can be written also as, right? So this will finally give you 1.67 0.0591 by 4 log of 10 raised to the power 7, 12, 1, 13, minus 13 when go in the numerator, it will give 10 raised to the power 13, 13 minus 6, it will give you the 7. So here is your final equation, 1.67 into 0.0591 into 7, log 10, you know, it is 1 actually. And if you solve this particular one, of course divided by 4 is here, then it will give you your answer. This would be somewhere around 1.75 volt, right? So this is how you can solve these kinds of the numerical. The only question is that there should be confusion between this, the pressure of gas, and this particular one. So this is the numerical, right? Now moving to the next question. So what is my next question? Okay, fine. This is given actually. Now this question is quite a straightforward and simple one. Nitrate ion in aqueous solution for the reduction electrode potential is given, 0.96 volts. So how I can solve this particular one? Say here, you see E standard is given as plus 0.96 volt. This value is given, and then you have given other values. See here, vanadium 2 positive reducing, and the potential is given as negative 1.19 volt. If you continue this question, then again you can see this Fe3 positive reducing, giving Fe. Similarly, gold ion and mercury ion, these all are there, and they have their respective electrode potential values. Now the question is, the pairs of the metals that is or are oxidized by the nitrate ion in the aqueous solution are, that mean these four pairs are given, and out of these four you have to predict which one would oxidize. So for this, I told you the trick in the last lecture. Higher the value of the reduction potential, higher would be the tendency of the metal to reduce, right? So this is having 0.96 volt. Any metal which will have higher potential higher than this one, it will reduce, and any metal which will have the potential lower than this particular one, that will oxidize. Now very quickly you can see this Fe3 positive reducing, it is having negative 0.04. So this value is less than this one. If you make the if you compare the electrode potential of these two, so this is having higher value, this is having lower value. So this would oxidize, and this iron Fe3 positive will this will reduce, and iron 3 positive would oxidize. So one option is here, you can write Fe3 positive, right, oblique Fe, you can write in this way, it will here oxidize. Similarly, this is 1.40 for gold, and now this for this iron which is used in the aqueous solution, it is the value of 0.96. that means this gold is higher value of having higher value of reduction potential, this is having the lower value of the reduction potential. So this gold will reduce and your given iron would oxidize. So this gold cannot be the correct answer. Now moving to the next one, mercuric ion 0.86 volt. Now this 0.86 is less than 0.96, that means this will oxidize. So another species that would that will oxidize, it is your mercuric, again it is oxidized. Now this particular one, you see vanadium. So vanadium is also having, you see this vanadium is also having the lower reduction potential than your nitrate ion, fine, so it will also oxidize. So next species is your V2 positive oblique V, it will also oxidize. So these three oxidize. Now you can check the pairs, actually vanadium and mercury both are there. So this A and B, this option A is correct, both will oxidize. Similarly, you can think mercury and Fe is there, so both are oxidizing, so this B is also correct. Now third is Fe and gold, but gold is not there in this case, so this C cannot be your answer. Similarly, your Fe and vanadium both are there, so this D is also your answer. So you see A, B, D, these are the answers, while C is not your answer. So this is how you can solve this kind of problem. Reduction potential of hydrogen half shell will be negative. So you have given the high pressure of the hydrogens and also the concentrations of your hydrogen ion. Now you have to tell which would reduce and which would oxidize in this question. So you should remember one thing, it is the key actually, or you can also say that it is the trick. Whenever your concentration, see, pressure of your hydrogen is greater than your the concentration of the hydrogen ion, in this case you will get the negative reduction potential, negative E0, fine. So reduction potential of the hydrogen half shell would be negative only when pH is greater, pressure of the hydrogen is greater than the concentration of the hydrogen ion. So in this case you can see the pressure of the hydrogen is 2, and the concentration of the pressure of hydrogen gas is 2, and the concentration of hydrogen is 1. That means option C is the correct one. So this is the question asked in the JEE 2011. So these are the sum of the numericals. Now moving to the next problem, you see my next problem is this this one, right? The Gibbs energy for the decomposition of Al2O3 is at 500 degrees centigrade is given as +966 kilojoule per mole, right? The potential difference needed for the electrode reduction for this one at least. So you have to calculate the potential difference which is needed for this electrolytic reactions, right? So this is the numerical. And you see how I can solve this kind of numerical. It's quite a straightforward and easy numerical based on your Gibbs free energy. And you know, this was your numerical, and this is the given data, 2/3 of alumina Al2O3 is reducing in aluminium. It's a metallurgic process actually. This is oxygen, delta G is given. So there are various ways to solve this reaction, but I'll solve this reaction stepwise so that you can have the clear idea about the reaction. So what is happening here? So what actually is happening in this reaction, you see your oxygen is here negatively charged, it is going to zero, that means it is undergoing change, and your aluminium in the ionic position, it is reducing, it is giving the value of the zero. So you can write the half reaction for this one. Oxygen, say two negative charge on there, And if you think how many 2 of oxygen supposed to, because you are forming O2 here, so 2 of these things are there. If it lose 4 moles of electrons, it will give you O2. So this is the first reaction, and this reaction is happening at anode, right? You know, at anode always oxidation is occur, so here it is oxidation is taking place. Anode oxidation occurs. Now, what is your second reaction? For second reaction, your aluminium is in 3 positive oxidation state. It is consuming 3 moles of electrons and depositing aluminium. So this process is the reduction. And you know, reduction, where this reduction occurs, reduction occurs at cathode. So this is your cathodic area. If you want to balance these electrons, so what you will do? You will multiply the first equation with 3 and you will multiply the second equation with 4. Say here I am writing 4. So how these equation becomes after multiplying with the coefficients 3 to the 6, that means 6 O 2 negative plus 3 4 is 12, that means 12 electrons are involved, and of course 3 of O2 would form. And in the second you are multiplying with the 4, that means 4 of aluminium 3 positive plus 12 of electrons, 4 3 is 12, and your 4 aluminium, right? So if you want to write the overall reaction for them, so you can cancel them out and straight away you can write 4 of aluminium 3 positive plus 6 of 2 negative, and you can form 4 of aluminium plus 3 of oxygen. So this is the balanced chemical reaction, overall cell reaction, right? But in your question you can give, you have given your aluminium 4 by 3, and here you are getting your aluminium 4. So what you can do, you can divide this equation by 3 so that it would become 4 by 3, right? Similarly, if you divide this by 3, so 3 3 would cancel and oxygen would remain. Now this one, if you divide it with 3, so 2 aluminiums are there, that means 2 2s are 4, then it will become 2 by 3. So this is how you can write. But while you are dividing this value with the 3, what about these electrons? That means 4, 12 electrons must also be divided by 4. So 12 electrons must also be divided by 4, and that will give you the 3. So that means in this reaction, sorry, that would divided by 3, not 4. So that will give you the value of the 4. What is the meaning of that? The meaning is that number of moles of electrons involved in this reaction is 4. Fine. If it is 4, then you can very easily calculate del G. Del G is equals to minus NF E, right? And you know, minus N is what? 4. Value of F is not given in the question, but you know numerically it is 96500. We can take this value as 96500 for calculations point of view. And of course this should be multiplied with electrode potential, and this electrode potential actually you have to calculate, right? Del G is given 966, but recall here it is given in the kilo calories, so you have to convert it into calories only. So here you can calculate your E standard, that would give you 966 into 10 raised to the power 3, that means 1000 divided by 4 into 96500, of course with negative sign, right? Your negative would not go anywhere, would negative sign would always be there. So if you solve this one, 2 of 2 this would cancel out, and see 2 5s are 10, 2 2s are 4, similarly 2 4s are 8, 2 8s are 16, 2 3s are 6. So 4 8 3, here you can write 4 8 3 into 5 divided by 9 6 5. So if you solve this particular one with negative sign, of course it will give you 2.5 of volt in negative sign. So this is your answer actually, and you can see here the options are given, and one of the option for this reaction, see 2.5 volt, it is given here. negative 2.5 volts. So your answer is negative 2.5 volts. It is asked in the JE 2017. So this question is from 2017. Fine. So what is the question actually? The standard reduction potential of cerium reducing to cerium 4 positive reducing to cerium 3 positive and iron 3 positive reducing to the iron 2 positive, and standard potential reduction potentials are 1.44 volt, 0.77 volt respectively, and you have to calculate the value of the log k. And one more thing, RT by F is given, and you see this is the reaction, right? So this numerical now I am going to solve. So how I can solve this numerical? Again, you can think in this way. So these are the given values actually. You can check, these are the given values. Now your work is to construct the equation actually for this one. So how you can write the equation, Nernst equation for this one. So it's again very easy. E cell equals to E standard cell negative RT by NF, and you see ln oxidized form. So you see here your iron is oxidizing, this is oxidation, and your cerium is reducing here, so this is reduction. So in the top your iron would be there, so this is the Fe2 positive concentration, and reduction would be downside. So here SCE cerium is here, there reduced species, that mean I am writing this one says cerium 4 positive in this way. Now so this is how you can make the equations. So this again I am telling you, I have explained how we can write the Nernst equation for the different redox reactions, right? If you haven't seen that video, so here is the link, you can go through the link. So now again I can find the answer very easily. So this is E cell and E standard cell, you see E cathode minus E anode, so this is actually E cathode minus E anode minus RT by NF ln, that is log to the base E, Fe2 positive and cerium 4 positive. Say it is given here, so you can write E cathode. So cathode, that means reduction, so this is the higher value and your cerium is undergoing reduction, it is going from 4 positive to 3 positive, so the value for reduction for this one, so 1.44 minus 0.77 volt, so this is 1 minus. Say one thing is given, RT by F is given in the question, RT by F is given in the question, right? So this RT by F you can straightforward write 0.0257 divided by N. So N means number of moles of electrons involved in the process. So in both the cases you see change in the oxidation number is only by the 1 unit, so the value of the N is also 1, because cerium 4 positive to 3 positive 1, iron 2 positive to 3 positive again 1, so you can write 1 here, right? And if you change the value of this natural log to the base 10, so you have to multiply this value with 2.303, this is the thumb rule. So Fe2 positive concentration divided by cerium 4 positive concentration. So to make it clear, I am writing it again. You can take the difference in between these two, right? So both would be say this one, positive, negative. So this value will give you 0.67, 1.44, you can write here, and 0.77, this is 7 again, this is 6 again, this is 0. So this value is like that, and this value when multiplied with this one, this is actually 0.0591 log. Now the concentration of the iron, whether it is given or not, you have to check this one. This is actually your log Kc actually. This actually your log Kc. So whether you write your Fe2 positive or Ce4 positive in this way, or you can write this it as log K. So E cell is here, and E cell is also given in the question. So what is the E cell? You see the reaction is the reversible reaction, and for this equilibrium, E cell would be zero. For when it is important to note that when there is the equilibrium between the reaction, then E cell would be zero, right? So this is zero equals to 0.67 negative of 0.0591 log of K. I am writing it as follows. Fine. So if you solve this value, log of K, that will give you 0.67 divided by 0.0591. Fine. So when you solve this, and after solving, if you take the anti-log of this one, so or not, you cannot, you will not take the anti-log. You can solve it as such. So on solving this one, so I am not solving. It is up to you how to solve this one. This is the simplest one. So this will give you 11.36. So value of log K in this case is this one. So all what's that's only you can remember whenever this reversible sign is there, that is the equilibrium is there, then E cell would be zero. So this is the value of this one. Now we can check what is the answer. So right now I am not having answer for this one, but it is coming out to this one. So you can check this equation also. So this is one of the questions. Now moving to the, so guys, here is my next problem, and my next problem is this particular one, which is the question asked in the exam examination 2014, right? If you see here, and these two equations are given where Mn2 positive is reducing to Mn and Mn3 positive is reducing to Mn2 positive, and for both this value 1.18, negative 1.18 of electrode potential is given, and for this one plus 1.51 volt is given, and you have to tell electrode potential for this reaction. As you know, in this reaction Mn2 positive, you can see here it is reducing and it is also oxidizing, so it's a disproportionation kind of reaction. As you know, the disproportionation reactions are those reactions in which the same species undergo oxidation as well as the reduction. So how I can solve this particular numerical, you can see in this way. This is how it is given in the question actually. E standard for this reaction, so number of moles of electrons 2, here you can write, right? And in this case here for this reaction, number of moles of electrons E1, and electrode potential is plus, and here it is minus. So what you can do, you can calculate the free energy for these reactions. This is the way of solving these kind of the reactions. So you can write del G3 standard, that would be equals to del G1 standard plus del G2 standard. For this one, you can write minus NF E3. For this one, you can write minus NF E1 plus, here again, write minus N F E2. How it is coming? It is coming from here. Del G is equals to negative N F E. So for three different reactions, I am writing the three different expression. So if you make this equation simpler, then you can find what you can write. You can change the sign. It will get plus, it will again get plus, and it will again get plus. So all would be plus, right? So you can write N FE3 on changing sign. Actually, you can write here on changing sign. So this would become NFE1, and here you can write plus NFE2. Now on further solving, so you can better solve it in this way: NE3 NF E1 by F plus NF E2 by F. So F would cancel, this would this cancel, this would one, this F would cancel this particular one. Now you left with NE3 equals to N of E1 plus N of E2. So for E3, you have to calculate electrode potential for this particular one. That means the final reaction. So you, if you check here, so here it is reducing. How many moles of electrons are involved? Say it is going from plus 2 to 0. So, and here nothing is changed. 3 to just 6. 2, 3 just 6. So you cannot count these species. But here you can clearly see the change in the electron is 2. Right. So here you can write 2 of E3. Clear? And that would be equal to N of E1. So this was your E1. How many moles of electrons are involved? 2 moles of electrons are involved. So you can write 2 for this particular one. And the potential is given. Potential is given negative 1.18. So you will write negative 1.18. Right. Then plus is there. And for is this in this reaction, how many electrons are involved? You can check again. So it is going from 1 to 2. So only you can check 2 moles, again 2 moles, not 1 actually, 2 electrons are also involved here. Because overall is your species to see 2, 3 is 6 and here you see 2, 2 is 4. If you write 2, 3 is 6, so here should be 2, 2, 2 is 4. So for better understanding, you can write in this way. 2Mn3 positive when consumes 2 moles of electrons will form 2 of Mn2 positive. So again the moles of electrons 2. So here you can write 2 and now it's electrode potential. So what is given here? It is given plus 1.15 volt. Right. So but you see in the question, so for this plus 1.51 volt is for your reaction when 3 positive is converting into 2 positive. But the question is asked in the way that 2 positive is going to the 3 is going to convert into 3 positive. That means reverse reaction is taking place here. So if this is having the potential, see if I am calculating for this one. So if it is having the plus 1.51 volt, so for this reaction, I will take this value as minus 1.51 volts. This is the key to solve this question actually. You have to reverse the sign of this one because these reactions are reverse, opposite. See, it is going from 3 to 2, it is going 2 to 3, so you have to reverse this sign. So now you will have say 2 8 16, 2 1 2 3 and 3 1 3. So 2 1 2. 2.36 with negative, and again you see negative, 2 1s are 2, 2 5s are 10, 2 1s are 2, 3, 3.02, right? So this is negative, this is again negative, and if you take this one, the negative negative would add together, so 3 to 5, so it would be 5, and this is point, and 3 is 3, 6 and 2, 8. So this is 2 of E3 actually. Now what is E3? E3 would be negative 5.38 divided by 2. So 2 2s are 4, 2 6s are 12 and 2 9s are 18. Negative. So answer is negative 2.69 volt. When electrode potential is negative, that means the reaction would not occur. So for this question, the correct answer is this particular one, negative 2.69, and reaction would not occur. This is how you can solve these kinds of the numerical.